Please welcome your next comic, my friend Matthew Broussard.
So much. How you guys doing? Good? Cool. Are there any Jews in the audience tonight? Identify yourselves. Go, please. It's scary when I ask, huh? Isn't it? I'm actually Jewish, despite this, but it's weird. I don't get to tell Jewish jokes without making people feel uncomfortable. Like, I learned that when I was really young. I was hanging out with my family by the lake. That's an unnecessary detail. And I just started to set up a joke. I said, hey, what did the Jewish girl say when she walked into, and then my uncle shushed me. I was like, what? He was like, yeah, you're not allowed to tell Jewish jokes. I was like, well, that's my religion. I had a bar mitzvah and everything. He's like, yeah, it's not just that you don't look Jewish. It's that you look like their natural predator. And I was like, what does that mean? He's like, I'll put it this way. You would have made Hitler feel conflicted, which very offensive. But I also love the imagery of that, of just like me in my apartment alone, like eating Kugel, like SS just breaks down my door and like, hey, you, no, really? On which side? Your mom's side? Yeah, that counts, okay. Well, listen, we don't normally do this, but you wanna be in our swim team? Swim team, as they would say? The reason I look like this, by the way, is I'm not full Jewish. My father wasn't. I'm a semi-Semite. My father was basically atheist, but he was Cajun, so I'm Cajun and Jewish, and that's a very rare mix, because Cajuns and Jews, they don't get along very well. You can actually tell how much the Cajuns hate the Jews by how they designed all of their food so Jews can't eat it. And if you don't follow, all Cajun food is either shellfish or pork, all of it. Every single gumbo, jambalaya, shrimp sauce, pecan, pork rinds, boudin. You know how not kosher boudin is? It's literally made of ground up pork wrapped in pages of the Old Testament. That's it. It's delicious. It's good. It's weird. I say I'm Jewish, but I don't go to temple. I don't really believe in God. Like, I'm basically just Jewish at this point for business purposes. And that's like most Jews. We don't believe in it. Like, I feel like Judaism is less of a religion and more just an alumni association. You know what I mean? Like, it's just like something you keep in your back pocket for job interviews. Like, you're a Jew? What year did you Jew? It's like, Temple Bethel, class 96, go Bobcats. Not the animal, Bobcats. He was our treasurer. He was a good guy. You like that one? Hey. Applause break for that. No, I don't deserve that. It's weird. I know the Jews have had some hard times, but what's weird for me is I have a hard time empathizing with it because I grew up Jewish in the 90s, which was a rare point in Jewish history. It was after there were actual Nazis, but before there were actual Nazis. Like, it was this weird sweet spot right in the middle. And like, I know anti-Semitism is bad, and I've seen a little bit of it in my lifetime, but all of it, it seems remarkably redundant to me. Every person I hear talking about the Jews saying bad stuff is basically just being like, yeah, the Jews, they're successful, but it's only because they're always helping each other out. They're always doing each other favors. And it's like, yeah, because the last time we didn't stick together, you almost got us. Like, we got to work as a team. So, I don't know. Jews are, our numbers are shrinking, if you don't know. I'll do holiday jokes eventually, but I have like 90 seconds worked in here. Jews, our population is shrinking. No one's trying to kill us for the first time ever, and our population's going down because of intermarriage, because we don't raise our kids Jewish. Like, we're great at math, but we can't multiply. It's amazing, and I just think that's so funny that we survived, like, the Holocaust and Inquisitions and slavery, and our biggest existential threat is Charlotte from Sex and the City. Like, that's what's gonna wipe us out. Some Jewish girl, I don't know. It's just, Judaism, I don't know. Christianity is a more fun religion. There's better holidays, you know what I mean? Like, we have Hanukkah, but it's not that great. The only reason Hanukkah is even like spoken of, even made a big deal, is because we just need something to compete with Christmas in that time slot. That's just, Hanukkah is our Mad TV. Like, it's our ants to their A Bug's Life. We don't really need it. And like, what does it celebrate? Christmas celebrates a virgin giving birth to your Messiah. Judaism celebrates that one time we made a candle last an extra long time. Like, we just stretched. That's the Jewiest thing you can celebrate. The only thing is, like, and Lag BaOmer celebrates that one time we brought back a rental car and empty and no one noticed. Like, that's the level of Jewish that it is. It's silly. We don't even have consistent start dates. I mean, like, we have the lunar calendar, and our holidays start at sundown when the first star comes out. You want to know when Christmas is, you look at a calendar. You want to know when Hanukkah is, you need Stonehenge and a sextant. Like, that's how you figure out when it all starts. What's the, I mean, we have, I guess, Passover. That's a big deal. Passover's our big one because it celebrates when Jews escaped slavery in Egypt and the last time a Jew did manual labor. That was actually 5,000 years ago. And what's funny is, I guess this is kind of offensive, but there's actually no historical record that Jews were slaves in Egypt. Like, that's just a thing that might not be. And I could so see that being a thing they just exaggerated over the decades, over the generations. Like, ugh, we were slaves to the Pharaoh, just slaves. It's like, weren't you guys all actuaries? I was like, yes, but metaphorically. The hours were terrible, not a good health plan. I could have closed on that, but I'm not gonna now. I have to stretch this out. I don't know, because so Cajun Jewish, I had to learn two languages. I didn't learn them. I had to study two languages growing up. I had to learn French, and French seems like a complicated language. It's not that bad. The trick to every French word is you look at the first three letters, you pronounce those, and then for the rest of the word, you just have a stroke. That's it. That's every French word. Just so many unnecessary letters. Like, you're just trying to shove them all in. Like, the French word for water is O, but it's spelled E-A-U, like, ugh, right? And the crazy part is that their word for O is spelled with three vowels, none of which are O, the word that it is. Like, how I asked for one syllable, you gave me three kids in a trench coat. Like, three vowels. Three vowels is most vowels. Do you understand? There's only five. And college kids get all offended, like, five vowels? What about Y? And it's like, Y is a consonant. And like, Y is a consonant and a vowel? And it's like, you're making me Republican. Like, this is why we lost. Just frustrating for me that because I had to learn Hebrew. It was the other language I had to learn from my bar mitzvah. And Hebrew is a language, if you don't know, with no vowels whatsoever. Like, if you ever wanted proof of how cost-efficient the Jews are, at some point in their history, someone was like, would you like to buy a vowel? And they're like, nah, we'll make do. Or maybe the Jews had vowels at one point, and they just sold them all to the French. And that's why they have too many. Just, we'll throw their, that's my closer. All right, thank you guys so much. Enjoy the rest of the show.
All right, guys, we're gonna keep this moving right along.